Hello and welcome to this segment of the program on AIT Infotech Network. My name is Hilary Damisa. A lot of decision making has been hampered by lack of adequate data and information management. As the president of the Institute of Information Management in Nigeria, can you share with us some of these issues?
In Nigeria generally, quite a number of people, if you ask them, they would tell you that information management, data management is important. People are yet to realize that information is an asset that they need to adequately manage. If we talk about information management, we're basically talking about what we refer to as the information life cycle. And what does that entail? It has to do with managing the process of information creation, information capture, the proper classification of those information, the proper storage, the proper infrastructure being put in place for information sharing and collaboration, and eventually, you know, the disposition of this information.
To you, Jasmine Oyemachi, what in terms of advocacy is the Institute doing in order to ensure that we have the requisite legislative framework for information and data management?
Okay. Thanks, Hilary, for that question. The truth is the agency has been, the Institute has been on a long journey, a long walk to bringing in the federal government into its mission and its vision. What have we done so far? We have spoken to the past people in charge, Minister of Information for the last dispensation, and before that. But we are hoping that very soon we will be given the platform with which to voice out our own advantages from IIM to the government. Hopefully our advocacy for information management within the NDAs and even the civil service itself would be heard. That's what we're hoping for.
In line with this, how is the Institute positioning to helping government achieve these objectives?
Well, thanks for that wonderful question. Because the Institute of Information has actually been harping on the need for information to be given adequate attention. I can authoritatively say here that for any government to succeed, there has to be need for information to be accorded the right attention, and for government to take information management seriously. For government to make any quality decision, there will be need for government to have access to quality information. If you don't have access to information, decision making is going to be a big problem. And why we have not been able to have past government achieve much in this country is the fact that in spite of all the billions you get to hear during the announcement of annual budgets, you hardly they are not commensurate with the level of results we get to see at the end of the day. It's simply because those budgets are not based on facts. They are not based on quality information. They are based on assumption. And whatever decision that is based on assumption, you don't expect to have quality results. So for any government that really wants to change the environment, that really want to have impact in the life of the citizens, then there is need for such government to give a P1, that is priority, to information management.
Would you say that the Institute of Information Management, I'm on to you now, Jasmine, has done enough to raise the requisite manpower development to be able to help Nigeria address the issue of information and data management?
I would say sincerely that its history as an institution, the wealth of knowledge, archived so far, would definitely help us reach that goal. But also, you would know that you'll have to be given some level of opportunity for you to gain certain information. Not all information is available to us at the moment, and that is what we are fighting for. Certain information should be made available so that we can
return. The number of terrorist victims or what information? Why not tell Nigerians?
Well, truth is, there's no government who would relegate any information that comes to it. Also, the information you send out to the populace creates a lot of reactions. Now, question is, what kind of reaction are you looking for? Let me take, for example, the issue of the budget having some certain issues in terms of information, in terms of its assumed balance. Those informations are not actually supposed to hit the public until it is time for it to hit the public. So if institution of information management is given the opportunity to handle such a project, the information that goes out will be information that will definitely impact,
positively
to the government itself as a body, to Nigeria as a people, to the outside world. Because however we project ourselves is what the outside world sees us to be. So what information are we giving to foreign investors, for example? Are we telling them that we have issues with the department that's supposed to handle the budget? You understand? Those information are not supposed to just spit out. They're informations that are calculated. They are on a need-to-know basis. So these are the things that we are hoping that the government would give us here and allow us to handle certain very, very, very discreet areas in governance.
What are those things the institute is doing to helping manpower in terms of prevention and security of data and information?
Well, like my president said earlier, there are trainings that are being organized. Most of the time they are centered around schools, they are centered around organizations, around the civil service also. And the idea is to train people on how to manage information, how to disseminate information, how to archive information that should be timed. There are certain informations that should go out at a particular time. Because it's not even in our curriculum in the first place, a whole lot of people come out of the university and you really do not understand what information management is. It's supposed to be a priority amongst your course.
Thank you, our guests, for coming on the show.
Thank you.